Hello everyone, this is Matt the Speedstar, aka the Gaming Rebel here, ready to run through the next part of The Legend of Zelda, Breath of the Wild. Last time, we made a tower rise up. If I can get the camera control right, it's right over there. We got the Great Plateau Tower to rise up, we got a map of the place, and we learned a little bit of history about what happened. And what happened was, Ganon took control of Hyrule Castle, and he's been sealed there for the last 100 years. Why'd I pull my bow out? I have no arrows anyway. But the entity now known as Calamity Ganon is there, sealed up in Hyrule Castle, just waiting to get out. And something needs to be done, otherwise the world's gonna end. And the first thing we're gonna do is we're gonna get a paraglider. How we do that? We're finally gonna enter one of these things. I could also skip this if I want, but I'm not going to. Anyway, Sheikah Slate confirmed. Let's go in. Well, once all this happens. Oh, travel gate registered to map. Access granted. Okay, open up for me. Thank you. Okay. Oh, and one more thing. I learned I have multiple autosaves, but I only have one actual manual save file, so if I done goof up a recording, I need to make sure not to save before I've gotten everything taken care of. Because once I save, that's it. All that is saved, and unless I have an actual autosave that happens like very close to when I last save, I'm screwed. So I have to be very careful. Kind of like what I did with Shantae Half Genie Hero and I think another game. I don't know. Just wanted to bring that up real quick. That's one point. That's one negative for this game that I just gotta say. You only have one manual save file. You have multiple save files, but you only have one manual save. And that kind of sucks. Anyway, let's head down here. I'm going to keep this one in. Just this little transition here, I'm going to keep it in just this once. Because you didn't really get to see it. You also see it on the... You see it at the start when you're, like, booting up a save file. You see it as it loads up everything. To you who sets foot in this shrine, I am Omen Owl. In the name of the goddess Hylia, I offer this trial. The Magnesis Trial. We're finally getting this. You guys know what this is. You guys have seen all the videos. But now we're finally in a Shrine of Trials. Huh. I kind of like how the music sounded before. But anyway, let's get this Magnesis that it talks about. Sheikah Slate authenticated, distilling rune. And once again, the Sheikah Eye is going to shed a tear, which will give us a little something special. Sorry, it took me a moment to follow up with what I was going to talk about. But now we have access to ruins. Not ruins like destroyed stuff, runes. Rune extracted. The Magnesis Rune. Grab onto metallic objects using the magnetic energy that pours forth from the Magnesis Rune. Objects held in the magnetic snare can be lifted up and moved freely. Oh, the fun we are gonna have with this! Anyway, as we're going through here, I never really, got into my whole, thing about the tablet. Because I did talk about it, but I didn't really get to finish with what I was doing. Yay, we have the little music there. So anyway, that's our Magnesis Ruin. I have to use the right control stick to do that. Cancel so I can drop it over here and drop it in the water. Oh wait, that's not water. Okay. It sounded like it for a second. Anyway, the whole tablet thing. Now, I talked about how I was using a tablet for something. And I never really got into it. Link, please get out of the water. I would like to stay out of the water as much as I can. Oh. Okay, so yeah, there is water down here. So, yeah. I heard right. Okay. Anyway, before I continue, I'm just gonna mention one thing about the Shrine of Trials. You guys probably already know about this. For the Shrine of Trials, you cannot climb up the walls. You can try, you can't. They're so smooth that you can't do it. So, you can't utterly break this by, like, climbing around and doing stuff. You have to play a little smarter. Pull you out. Cancel, because I don't think I need you. Oh, right, I have to jump! Uh-oh. That would be a guardian, I believe, and I'm gonna stay back here while... how do I target... Oh! Oh, son of a... Yeah, I... Good thing I was blocking. So apparently, never mind. It's like, target with ZL and you have to hold it this time. I don't think you can actually switch it to, just switch. I think you actually have to hold it. That's gonna kind of suck, actually, because I'm used to the switch style of targeting. Well, guess this means I have to learn. Alright, you over here. And down you go. Perfect. Almost perfect. Oh, good. I can just... Yeah, I let go of the button, so thankfully I don't have to worry about that. There. Now I have a bridge. Oh, wait. I think if I remember right, I can use this. And bring my little treasure over here and pull it towards me. Cancel. And claim the spoils. Another traveler's bow. Can never have too many bows. Oh, okay. Now I remember how to do this. That's not what I want. This is what I want. I'm a sword person, I'm not a club person. Okay, back to the tablet story. So, before I even knew of Let's Playing and all that, what I used to do a lot of was drawing. I guess I'm not going to be talking about it during the Shrine of Trials because I'm already done. I'm at the end. See? Nothing else. Let's go over here and let's examine this. Nice effect. Nice touch. You have proven to possess the resolve of a true hero. I am Omen Ao, the creator of this trial. I am a humble monk blessed with the sight of Goddess Hylia and dedicated to helping those who seek to defeat Ganon. With your arrival, my duty is now fulfilled. In the name of Goddess Hylia, allow me to bestow this gift upon you. Please accept this spirit orb. And then after he gives me the spirit orb, which is probably his soul or something, he dies. Oh, I'm so liking that. Spirit orb! We also got the da-da-da-da-da! I love that. A symbol of courage given to those who have overcome the challenges of a shrine. May the goddess smile upon you. Hey, and there he goes. Fades away into nothingness. Because now he can finally rest in peace. Now that I finally come out of here. Okay. I'll keep this one in too, just to show you the thing where you can skip different hints. Oh! I know that hoe. It seems you managed to get your hands on a spirit orb. Well done. Paraglider, please? You know what? Yes. I'm saying that. I encourage you to slow down for a moment, my courageous friend. The appearance of those towers and the awakening of this shrine. It is all connected to that Sheikah slate you carry on your hip there. Paraglider, please? I have yet to finish speaking. Yeah, Paraglider, please. That's the name of this. That's the name of this video. Long ago, a highly advanced tribe known as the Sheikah inhabited these lands. They were also very well known to be ninjas. And apparently, they are now technological ninjas. My favorite kind. Anyway, the great power of their wisdom saved this kingdom time and time again. But their ancient technology disappeared long ago, or so it is said. Yeah, because we didn't need it. Last time I remember, there's always a hero who actually comes to save the land of Hyrule time and time again. It's not the Sheikah. It is interesting, however, to think how something like that survived all this time, hidden away in a shrine. These shrines are tucked away in numerous places all over the land. There's 119 more to go, too. On this plateau alone, I believe there are still 3 more. Bring me the treasure from each of those shrines, and I'll give you my paraglider. Oh my god. That wasn't the deal! Oh, I suppose I changed my mind. Screw you, old man! Just screw you! Oh. Okay, he's feeling generous. Maybe this'll actually make up for having to get the rest of them. It's always best to survey the area by looking around from a high point. Let's see here. How about you make your way to the top? Are you joking? I love that. It's just the responses. I love that. I have another little trick. Oh, are we finally getting this? Because I remember hearing about this. By the way, River of the Dead, that's kind of... That is kind of... I don't even want to get into that. Anyway, see those blue icons? You should recognize the cave from where you woke, the shrine you came from, and the tower. Yes! Warping! So at least now, I can go back to the tower, I can go back here, and I can actually go back to the shrine if I want. The isolated plateau. Okay. So let's see what... Let's see about this. Okay, current location... Great Plateau Travel. Great Plateau Travel. Oh, man. You probably can't see it right now, but I am just grinning from... The crap? Okay, wow, he surprised me right there. But, yeah, you probably couldn't see it, but I was grinning from like ear to ear just knowing about being able to warp this early in the game. Okay, where to next? Let's pull up that map again. Okay, so there are more shrines around here. He said look at a high place, so we're thinking Mount Hylia. Let's use a beacon. I like blue beacons. So I'll put that one there. And, once again, we are going to travel, and as usual, every time it does that transition where it shows me the hint, I am going to cut it. So I'll see you in a sec. I need to come up with something clever for that. And we're actually back in here. I was not expecting to actually go inside the Shrine of Resurrection, but now I can see why this is here. So we have our warp points. Very good to know. And that means I have to run all the way out. Run up here, climb up this. And do this again. Hello everyone, and welcome to Breath of the Wild again. Ooh, Okay, it is getting dark out, and enemies are probably gonna be getting a little restless now. But then again, I haven't seen too many of them. Alien shroom. Alien shroom. These are not the shrooms I want. Oh, right. I now just remembered that little story I wanted to talk about. Oh, he's back over there. So, I need to get over to Mount Hylia first. Before I do anything else, I need to figure this out. So, I gotta go around, and I gotta go this way. Okay. Good to know. So, I am heading in the right direction, I suppose. Grabbing. Apples. Because I need these. Oh. Oh, I just pressed the button. Or I can do that. I was not planning to do that, but whatever. So, the whole thing about the tablet is, before I knew of Let's Playing, I used to do a lot of drawing, and, like, this is a big hobby of mine. I love doing it a lot, and I kind of wish I still had that passion before, but I kind of lost that passion after a while, because one, life, and two, I got disturbed very easily. And by disturbed very easily, I mean how do I put it? I got upset about a lot of things, and they tended to distract me and just make me lose all motivation to draw. And it sort of declined a little bit. I need to get my sword out because I have keys and undead bokoblins to kill. And also, I'm taking his spear, so now I have a lance weapon. Link is now a master of arms. Ooh, I'm taking the arm. Yes, that is kind of gross. It's about as strong as... Oh, and key swings. So, getting stuff. As I try to talk a little bit, but yes, it's nighttime. Undead enemies are going to start coming after me. Hey, an ancient screw. Yay. Let's get some more tech, because I like tech. Anyway, back to the tablet story before the video ends, because I don't want this to be too long again. Oh boy, I know where that place is. I am not gonna like that. Anyway, let me continue my story. So, one thing I kind of started hating about drawing and doing it all digitally. Well, not doing it all digitally. I sketch it, I scan it, and then I work on it digitally. But it became such a chore, and I started not really liking it because it... Yeah, like I said, it became more of a chore, and it became less enjoyable. So, that was gonna be, a problem for me, and I just could not get myself to really get going with it. I really wouldn't mind going over there, but I kind of... don't want to until I've got that means to cook up these spicy peppers. I wonder if I can cook them over by the old man's fireplace. I wonder if I can do that. I'm gonna look at that real quick. And maybe watch myself because I'd like to not fall in the water and... Bloop, bloop, bloop. Also, I have to jump. Because I like jumping. Okay, back to the story. So, I got a tablet. I got a tablet because I figured it'd be a nice little thing to get me back into drawing more. Because I know a few friends who have tablets, and they're pretty damn good with them. I wanted to try it out, see what it was like, and at first, I didn't like it. But I had to figure something out with the whole tablet thing. And recently, like a couple days before I started playing this, or at least before I got this, I had a breakthrough in a way to make it so I could play. Like, not play. I'm getting distracted already. But I got a way for me to actually... Ooh, what are these? Hyrule herbs. Okay. And choo-choos. Crap. So let me just take care of these guys, and as I fight them, I guess I'll continue talking. as I get some chew jelly. I was about to say chew jelly, but whatever. I am going the absolute wrong way. I'm trying to find the old man, and I don't want to warp. Oh well, I'll probably find him next time, because I don't think I'm going up there until next video. Give me that. So, the thing I like a lot about drawing on paper is I have control. That's the thing I don't like with the tablet, is I have a lot less control because the surface is really smooth, and I have very shaky hands. Or at least in terms of shaky hands, they're really shaky and it's hard to actually control my hands all that well. Is this the old man? I think this is the old man. Wake him up. Could you not see I was sleeping? What are you doing? If I can't hunt, what else is there to do but sleep? Sitting by a warm campfire is past way. Blah, 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 blah. Are you hungry? Yes, I am going to cook something. Got any tips? Simply open your inventory, grab all your ingredients, and toss them in. Try and consider how the ingredients will complement one another. If you play your cards right, you may even end up with a dish that can help protect you from extreme cold. Just like a fairy suit. Except consumable. And doesn't last forever. Also, I'm taking your arrows. And your torch! Okay. I'm just gonna do this real quick. Which one... Right. No, 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 no. I want the torch. Where is the torch? Okay, and I'm gonna take your traveler's bow, too. So, wait. Where the crap is my torch? Give me a second. I need to figure out where the stupid thing is. Where is it? Did I drop it or something? Let's drop this, and let's drop this, because I don't need these anymore. Where's the freaking torch? You can pass time by the fire. No. Where did that torch go? What the crap? Oh, here it is. Okay, now I see it. Yeah, okay. That was really weird. Take. There we go. No. I didn't want to take that. Okay. Now, let's try some cooking. So anyway, what I did with the tablet thing is I took a piece of paper and I put it over the surface, not sure if it was going to work or not. Hold, 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 hold. Return to game. Cook! Give me something good. Spicy sautéed peppers! Yes! So there we go. Gives me a lot of health, but it will also, let me withstand extreme cold for a little bit. But, I'm not gonna do that for a little bit. I'm gonna wait until next time before I go into the extreme cold. Anyway, I put a piece of paper over top my surface of my tablet. I actually put the pen to it. It actually works. So now I have the comforts of drawing on paper while being able to draw on a tablet. And I'm going to be doing that a lot for my channel art, which hopefully will be up pretty soon. Probably not by the time this is up, but hopefully sometime soon. So I'm going to cut it here. We've done a lot. I just wish I got that paraglider, but unfortunately we're not getting that for a little bit. So next time on Breath of the Wild, we are going to go into the extreme cold area that is Mount Hylia, and we're going to see if we can find another Shrine of Trials, because we have to find 3 more of those bad boys in order to actually get that paraglider from him. So, until next time, thank you all for watching. If you like this video, please give it a like. If you wish to follow along with this and my other Let's Plays, please consider subscribing. If any concerns come up, I'll let you guys know my Twitter. And additional info in the lower left box in the video and down in the description below. This has been Matt the Speedstar, aka The Gaming Rebel, and I will see you guys next time when we run through the next part of Breath of the Wild.